started here, so we are not complete strangers. My name is Lauren. I am 16 years old. I'm going to be a senior this year at Williams Bay High School. This is my third year working here at the cruise line, but it's just my second year getting tours out here on the boats. I'm also a retired mule jumper here on the cruise line, but I will go into detail about that a little bit later on in the tour today. We're going to start off our tour with that modern brick building behind the Riviera Beach. That is the Geneva Public Library. This cruise-style building was designed by Mr. James Dresser, a student of the famous architect Frank Lloyd Wright. A property along the shoreline is known as Library Park. Mary Sturgis,
one of my most sorry stories, if y'all can hear me, we're on a boat tour, a 4-hour boat tour. So, let's go down the river, the lake, river, the lake. We're going down the lake, so let's go down the lake. Oh, yeah, lake. Lake Geneva. Let's go down the lake and get started. Let's go.
To you, it was yours to drive home.
serve children from urban and low-income communities, and it is still funded almost entirely by Lake area residents and summer visitors. See us home high up on the hill next to us, they have that beautiful golf course, swimming pool, and tennis courts. The Abbey Springs development is built on a site of the Edward G. Ayer estate known as the Oaks, and it was constructed in 1875 and included 1,200 acres of property. It was named for the abundant oak forest and took up 500 acres of the Ayer estate. The stone boathouse along the shore and some of the walls along Lakeshore Drive and two of the barns are all that remain of the original buildings. Mr. Ayer was in the lumber business and was a co-owner of Oaks. You may be able to figure out who lives there. Civil War hero who visited the lake. Many famous sailors have come from the Lake Geneva Yacht Club. Most notably was Mr. Buddy Melgus. Buddy Melgus is the first man in history to win a gold medal in the Olympics and go on to win the America's Cup. Buddy still sails here on Geneva Lake in the A-boat fleet, which are 38-foot-long boats with 67-person crews. He's quite competitive, and he still often wins races with beautiful ceramic tiles. In 2005, after winning a 10-year court battle with neighbors not wishing for the estate to become a museum, one of Mr. Sipes' great-grandsons, the late William Peterson, who was the steward of the property, donated this home and its contents to the state of Wisconsin. Includes 500 feet of lakefront.
You can't see that house behind all them trees.
Mr. Peterson passed away in March of 2013 at the age of 85. The property has now been designated a state historical site.
West is original site. The club was founded by a group of summer residents who were leaders of Chicago's business and industry and moved the state safety throughout the decade. This is not the original clubhouse, however. The original was a wooden structure with gable roofing, which burned out in a 1915 fire. The building was built with the front piece of the golf course rather than the lakes, that there be no mistake as the club's true purpose. The club is only open May through October and still a private country club with a small membership limited to about 220 members and their families. Thus, some of those families have been with the club for several generations ever since its founding. And upside down in the water, they had finally considered that it was unsafe for use. That current owner wants to bring lights to preserve the original center section. gold-plated with matching solid stone silver on the second. Ceilings in the mansion are hand-carved out of mortar and lavishly decorated by import European artists with breathtaking oil paintings.
Dragonfly.
On the main floor was a beautiful ballroom complete with a crystal chandelier, huge mirrors, and an ornate pink marble fireplace. That hand-carved dining room table could comfortably seat 100 guests. Also on the main floor were a parlor, library, music room, game room, butler's pantry, and a vast kitchen. And the second and third levels are basically just bedrooms and bedroom suites. The fourth floor is designed for recreation and even contained a gymnasium and a miniature golf course. Now, originally that roof was a garden, but not just any garden. Someone had the idea of planting willow trees up there. But as we all know, as trees grow up, their roots do grow down, so it created quite some structural damage. But I think they made the most of it, seeing as they added a rooftop swimming pool in its place. Even the two-level basement was elaborate, including a three-lane bowling alley, jewelry vault, huge laundry and drying rooms, and a mammoth pool storage room with a double boiler system. That lowest level was used for ice storage. In the winter, they would harvest large blocks of ice out of the lake and store them for summer use as an air conditioning system. Now, Mr. Young only enjoyed the home for 5 years before his death, but the mansion remained in the family until 1939, when Otto Young's granddaughter presented the home on about 8 acres of surrounding land to the Episcopal Church to be used as a private school for girls. Now, unfortunately, the school failed financially after a few years, and financial problems have followed the home ever since. In the early 1960s, the mansion was taken over by Walworth County for back taxes. A tax auction was held and was bought by a developer for just $75,000 in back taxes.
What?
But since then, several million dollars have been spent in the restoration of the building. In the 1970s, the main level was transformed into an elegant French restaurant known as the Stone Manor Inn. The restaurant experienced financial problems and was then forced to close. Now next came the failed Christmas Tree Museum. Yes, you heard that right. Christmas Tree Museum. We're still all scratching our heads as to why that one didn't quite work out. In the 1980s, it was purchased by a Chicago couple and converted into 7 luxury condominiums. Now, the past winter of 2018 came the announcement that it was purchased by Tina Trahan. She's the wife of the CEO of Starz Cable Network. She has purchased 6 of the 7 condominiums and has invested $13.5 million into its repair and updating just to spend 6 weeks each summer here. Now that does conclude the story of the largest single family home ever built on the lake, originally called Yarnett's Day North.